Thank you, everybody, for joining me here today. Had a lot of folks reaching out over the last 24 hours, so I wanted to address you guys all together. What you've continued to see is incredibly unfortunate for the people of Oklahoma. What you've seen are political attacks directed at me from the Speaker of the House, Charles McCall, and his buddy, Mark McBride. They have continued to attack my office with baseless lie after baseless lie with no evidence. Oklahomans deserve a good education system. Oklahomans deserve the education reforms that we are bringing them in my agency. I will not continue to stand here and listen to Speaker McCall and Mark McBride lie about my office and lie about what the work we are doing. So what we've seen here is a clear political attack. And why are we getting that political attack? Because Charles McCall is more concerned about running for governor in 2026 than taking care of Oklahomans. This is a clear attack on who he views as his biggest political opponent in that governor's race in 2026. My focus is kids in the state of Oklahoma. I'm not worried about a future election. I'm worried about ensuring every kid has the best education possible. So because of that, I'm going to stand here today and say, if Charles McCall and Mark McBride want to continue to throw these baseless lies and accusations at me, they need to do two things. The first is they need to provide all of the evidence for these political lies to the Senate. The Senate should see what these accusations are and the evidence behind them. I will go ahead and cut to the chase. There is none. There is no evidence. These are political lies from the Speaker and Mark McBride. And then the next thing that they need to do, we don't need to wait. We do not need to wait on a loft committee. We do not need to wait on an investigation. It is time to start the proceedings immediately. The Speaker wants to impeach me for political advantage in the 2026 governor's race. So then let's start the impeachment proceedings. I am calling on Speaker McCall and Mark McBride to begin their impeachment proceedings Monday. It is time for Oklahomans to have the answers. I have provided them a record amount of information. I continue to provide their offices with a record amount of information and documentation. I want the people of Oklahoma to see everything that my agency is doing. I want the people of Oklahoma to see everything that's being done here in this Capitol. And so I welcome those proceedings to start Monday, if that's what this is about. If this is truly about getting to the bottom of those political accusations from the Speaker's office, let's have the impeachment hearings and let's lay them all out for everybody to see. Let's not say that there's gonna be a loft hearing that starts some period in the future. Let's not call it different things. We know what they're trying to do here, it is obvious. As a matter of fact, it was declared by Randy Weingarten 2 months ago. The head of the National Teachers Union put my picture on stage and drew a target over me and said they were coming after me. 6 weeks later, you see the Speaker, Charles McCall, through his surrogate, Mark McBride, launch these political attacks on me. I will not back down to the Teachers Union. I will never apologize for fighting for Oklahoma families. I will never apologize for ending woke indoctrination in our schools. I will never apologize for bringing the Bible back to the classroom. I will never apologize for fighting for school choice. I will never apologize for fighting for the parents of Oklahoma. And so that is my demand of the Speaker. End the political gamesmanship, end the fake political attacks, end the fake controversies. If you have any evidence for these lies, provide them over to Senate leadership, and let's start that impeachment investigation Monday morning. Folks, that's what I had. I said we got plenty of time for questions, so whoever wants to go first.
Is this your first announcement that you're running for governor in 2026?
No, absolutely not. I have two things I'm saying here today. Charles McCall is concerned about running for governor in 2026. My focus is the education system for our kids. My focus is ensuring this is the greatest school year we've ever had for the kids of Oklahoma. I could care less about future elections. Not on my radar whatsoever. My concern is getting to the bottom of this. So again, if there's a serious accusation, Let's deal with it Monday. Let's get it out there. Let's deal with it. By the way, I know most of you here in the media, this has happened every single year since I've been in office, hasn't it? Federal funds won't get to schools, right? That's what they say every year. Federal funding, where is it? They say this every year, and what happens? I've gone through a Loft hearing. What did Loft say? No issues with federal funding. We went through that entire process. Audits every year. No issues with the flow of federal funding. This has been a repeated attack on my administration from day one that has escalated because of his gubernatorial aspirations. Not mine. My concern is the job that I'm doing right now, and it's making sure every single child has the best education possible. I mean, I really don't have much of a reaction. I mean, you know, I have laid out the case. I've shown that since April, we were telling districts about when their federal funds is, and he lied about it. You know, so he wants to throw a frivolous lawsuit at me. That's his prerogative. Everybody has the right to do that. It just, that is so not worried about that whatsoever. I am focused on the education system for our kids. We've got to bring, look, here's the reality, and you guys know this about me, and Oklahomans know this. I'm going to always speak directly to the people of Oklahoma. I'm going to be very open. I'm going to be very open with why I'm doing the things I'm doing. I'm going to be very open about the agenda that we have on behalf of the state of Oklahoma. I try to represent every Oklahoma parent the best that I can. And I'm telling you right now, these are fake political accusations trying to create an impeachment scenario on me. They're calling them other things. They're saying it's under Loft, it's this, it's that. No, it is the Speaker Charles McCall and Mark McBride trying to impeach me for that future governor's race. And just to be clear, Mark McBride said it. Channel 9, News 9, he's on there 2 days ago in the morning, says this is about a future governor's race, and this is a political attack. He said that live on TV. So they have admitted that's what this is about. Now they're trying to lie to other members. And by the way, I've talked to a lot of members of the House that have said, hold on a second, that's not the way it was described to me. I've had members who say, I didn't sign that letter. They put my name on there. I've had members who say, they didn't tell us that you provided all that information. So you've seen an active lie being pushed by Mark McBride at the direction of the Speaker. And so they can't have their cake and eat it too. Come right out. If these accusations are true, let's start the impeachment proceedings Monday and let's go.
Are there some superintendents in the state that you can suggest that we call to verify that they're receiving their funds as they have in the past and everything's on schedule?
I mean, sure. We're happy to show you all that. Money went out before we said it would, by the way. So we told districts back in April when money would be out. We've given them updates over the last few weeks. We sent that email out. I've seen it kind of kicked around a little bit. We actually got them out before then. So yeah, I mean, you can ask whoever, ask our office. We're happy to show you and whatever, however you show that and the documentation of when it exactly dropped, but happy to do that. Yes,
sir. At the last Loft meeting, you admitted that $1.4 million in federal grants were left unused on the table. Are you saying that's not true?
We're talking about a federal grant process, and by the way,
you blamed previous employees for that. You said previous employees were blamed.
Sure, yes. We're looking at every dollar for Oklahoma kids. There's several grants. I've told you, we've turned down several grants. The media, you guys love to attack us on a security grant we didn't apply for. We are now about to receive multiple record amounts of federal funding for school security. And again, like Loft pointed out, frankly, there is a lot of misunderstandings about federal monies. We are going after a ton of different grants for a ton of different reasons, and that has been lied about in the press to try to target us. So here's the reality. We apply for grants, we use grants, we make them available to schools, and this is a fake controversy. So we're going to continue to do that. We're going to continue to use monies as it's appropriate for our kids. I don't. You know, I've always worked well with Chairman Wallace. You know, look, here's what I've seen. What I've seen is, I've talked to so many members this week. What I've seen is Charles McCall's given direction to Mark McBride. Mark McBride, you guys have seen it. He's fought me for 3 years. He admitted this was about the governor's race, said it on TV, said it was a political attack. Now, there are a lot of other people getting caught in the crossfire on this. I talked to members on that list that said, hold on a second. I didn't sign that list, or they told me this, they told me that. So there's a lot of folks that are getting caught into this. And what I would say is let's bring it all out in the open. I'm happy to sit down with any member of the House. I'm happy to show them all the information that, and by the way, Mark McBride was joking around on TV, said, I've got a stack of papers from SDE this high. Yes, so on one hand, we don't provide information to him. On the other hand, he's got 4 feet high stack of documents from the agency. you just see, it's all falling apart. The lies are falling apart. And we're ready to get it out in the open. Let's lay it all out there for everybody to see. And let us get back to bringing about the biggest education reform the country's ever seen in our schools. Let's stop the political gamesmanship. And let's get back to doing the work for our kids. I haven't seen that. Again, I'm trying to be very direct with you all about what I know. I'm trying to be very direct with you guys and about conversations I've had with members. And so that's what I'm going to say on that one.
When was the last time you sat down with Paul or McBride to talk through some of these issues?
They have my number. All these concerns, every time they ask for paperwork, they get the paperwork. Every time they ask for more information, they get the more information. And then you need more information, let us know. Again, we've provided Mark McBride a record amount of information. If they have more questions, ask us. If they need more information, ask us. And again, that's why I'm asking for an open hearing. Let's go. Let's lay it out there. Let's let everybody decide. Again, I'd like for you all to be in the room. Let's run it live. Let's see where are these accusations. And frankly, he needs to share them with the Senate. You saw the Senate's comments today. If there's some serious accusations here, they should see the evidence too. And I think that's the only way to proceed with the amount of political accusations that they are making. We need to lay it all out there. I'm tired of the innuendo. I'm tired of not being upfront with Oklahomans that you're seeing from the speaker and Mark McBride. Let's lay it all out there. Let's let everybody see it. Let's decide.
Which legislators said their names weren't supposed to be on that list?
I'm going to let them be the ones to say that. I know some have already gone public with that. Some are debating whether they are. And I'm going to keep those conversations confidential. But one legislator has posted that. And Mark even said it. You know, Ross Ford wasn't supposed to be on there, and Mark pulled his name off. So I don't want to, I'll let the other members speak how they want to speak, but that's the one that's been public, and I'll leave it at that. Thank you.
If there is funding miss or appropriation or anything, would you set down?
Look, there's no misappropriation of funds. That again, this is what you've seen as a narrative in the media that's a complete lie. There's no misappropriation of funds. And again, by the way, when we have legal questions, notice what we do. We've kicked those over to the Attorney General. Attorney General, we have a legal memo. We think it could be gray. Please provide us better guidance. We want to ensure that what we're doing is above the law. I think that's crystal clear. I think Oklahomans respect that. We are trying to be good stewards of taxpayer dollars. We're trying to ensure everything that we're doing is above board legally. So if we have a question, we send it over to the Attorney General, Gettner Drummond, and say, please give us further guidance. And you guys have seen this with the open records request too. We asked him for more guidance. Here's what we've done. We explained the personnel staffing up that we did. I'm sure somebody was going to ask me about that, but we explained to the Attorney General, here's the staffing we've put on it. Here's the changes in processes. If there's something else that you would have us do, please let us know. We are trying our best to meet an unparalleled demand from the media and from the public. And so this is what we've done. What can we do better? We are very open about that. We're very open about our processes, and that's what we're going to continue to do.
But when they heard you missed out on $1.4 million at the last law meeting, and to stop the school violence and stuff like that, that's taxpayer dollars that didn't get used.
No, there are decisions made in the agency about money coming in, money going out, where it is to be spent. We have brought in a record amount of federal funding to the state of Oklahoma. That's a fact. We brought in record amount of federal funding to the state. We have applied for record amounts of school security grants. These are facts. Now, you can shake your head, but that's the truth. So we are continuing to be the most effective administration we've ever seen. You're seeing it from our schools. You're seeing record turnarounds at TPS. You're seeing record turnarounds at OKCPS. And that's what you're going to continue to see in my administration. So despite what the media may say or what their lies may be out there in the media, we're going to continue to fight for Oklahomans. No, we responded to that. I don't remember the date, but yeah, we gave them a response. I don't remember the date, but yeah, yes, ma'am. We sent them an email back and said, here's what we're doing, here's why we did it this way, what would you suggest?
And have you heard back from them since then?
No.
Have you submitted the Attorney General request for the question of lawmakers attending executive sessions? I know you had said that you would. I think I was told yesterday that they hadn't received that specific request, they'd received three others, but not that one. Do you plan on doing that?
Yeah, just to be clear, we have sent over multiple inquiries about it. So we haven't asked for an official opinion. We asked for some specific situations and said, here's the situation. What would you recommend? So that's the conversations with the Attorney General before the next board meeting. But yeah, there hasn't been what's the official opinion? It was, here's the situation. Here are the lawmakers involved. Here's what the executive session was about. And then the question was posed to them. So how would you advise us deal with this? So that's the one that's pending.
As a state agency, shouldn't you
It's not a problem. This has followed the same track it has every year, and that's part of what you've heard me talk about in the press. We tell districts in April within 10 to 15% of what the feds will give them. So districts know that in April. As we roll into the beginning, and again, remember, this is federal dollars, so we have to rely on the federal government to verify the numbers and then give us the money. Then when we move closer to August, we begin to give updates of the feds have told us we can expect to draw down on these dates. Here's the exact numbers. So we give them the estimates early. We walk them through. So again, districts know within about 15% of how much they'll get the next year. And the timelines remain the same. And again, we've looked at different years in the past. A lot of it depends on when do the feds give you that first number? When do they verify it? So the process has stayed the same since I've been here and in previous administrations. The process hasn't changed. Oh, look, I have no issues with law. I mean, again, we worked really well with Loft last year. And again, remember, Loft looked over our federal monies and federal grants last year. We just did this. And again, we had a great working relationship with them. We were very open, like we have been with the auditor, the federal auditors. I launched my own third-party audit when I took over the agency. We love audits. We love to be very open and transparent. So there's no issue with Loft. But what I'm trying to say is, if there's a serious accusation like the speaker is leveling, let's put it out. What are we waiting on? Let's not call it something else. It's an impeachment effort on their part. So let's go ahead and do it. Let's bring it out there. Let's talk about it. Let's put it out in the open. But yeah, no, I've got no issues with talking to Loft, working with Loft. Again, I think they've done a great job to walk folks through where money is, and we just did it. So yeah, no problem there.
Do you think your messaging should change? You call superintendents clowns. You call teachers leftists, Marxists, communists. Do you think that could have something to do with the fact that representatives and people are saying this stuff? The messaging that you're putting out is not the best, maybe?
I represent the people of Oklahoma. I represent the families of all 77 counties in the state of Oklahoma. Went to all 77 counties, won a statewide election. By the way, folks, it wasn't close. All my elections were not close. I crushed my opponents. I won every election because we listened to Oklahoma parents. We watched an education be captured by left-wing activists and the teachers union, and we took it back and put parents in charge. We took out the woke indoctrination and we focused on outcomes. We've put in free market approaches like merit pay and school choice, and you're gonna see the results from those things. So I will continue to fight unapologetically for Oklahoma parents and their values, and so I'm gonna continue to do that.
Governor Sid, actually on that same topic, just spoke at the panel as part of the, what was called Better Conversation, mm-hmm. Disagree Better, at the Oklahoma Volume Memorial a couple days ago. After that, my editor asked him kind of about just news concerning you and things the last week or so, and he said that he wished that, you know, some of the rhetoric might not be as strong, some of the name calling would go away, things like that. How do you respond to some of these elected Republicans, including Governor Stitt, saying that they wish that some of your rhetoric would be not quite as strong?
I'm going to continue to unapologetically represent the people of the state of Oklahoma. When they come under attack and our values come under attack, I'm gonna be very open and honest with the people of Oklahoma about what's happening, who's doing what lies are being told. Again, you see me here today, and you guys, again, I've gotten to know some of you very, very well over the last couple of years. I try to be very open and honest about why we do the things we're doing. We have been the most transparent administration in state history. I talk to you guys often. We try to make sure that the public knows what's going on. And so when I see the Oklahoma values under attack by left-wing groups, again, I told you, Randy Weingarten from the National Teachers Union puts my face on stage and says, we're going after this guy. And we watched those groups organize and work together against, and by the way, they're coming after me, but just to be clear, they're after the parents of Oklahoma. They are after our values, they're after our families, and I'm standing between them and these radical attacks. So I'm gonna continue to do that. I'm gonna continue to call those things out when those things happen. And again, it is an open, honest conversation with Oklahomans that I'm not gonna apologize for. I'm gonna continue to speak very clearly to the people of Oklahoma and continue to build a coalition to move the state forward in education.
Why did it take you so long to ask the AG opinion on these specific limits bills and the funding bills? You know, because now it's putting the schools in danger and they may not be getting enough funding.
Well, that's a great question, Haley. So what we did is we worked with lawmakers from the House and the Senate to find solutions. Okay, this is gray. Can we come to a consensus on how we move forward? I thought we were close to consensuses on all the issues. Those talks broke down. I could not get clarity that the Senate and the House completely agreed with our interpretation. And so when that happened, I said, we have got to go to the Attorney General, because this is frankly not even a policy disagreement, it's a legal one. And really the only way that we're going to move forward when there's different legal opinions on issues this strong is to kick it over to the Attorney General. So frankly, in those topics, there really hasn't been a policy disagreement. It has been legally, can we do the things that one of the chambers want to do? And again, it hasn't been clear. And so that's where we decided, hey, when those talks broke down and it was clear the consensus wasn't there any longer, that's when we moved for an AG opinion to try to clarify that.
So on the inhalers, you know, there's the letter from both Wallace and Senator Paul where they're agreeing on how to delve it out. What was that not?
We went to OMES, we asked, can we legally sole source it? And we saw from our legal counsel that we couldn't. So we offered a path forward to say we can reimburse the inhalers. And that wasn't agreed to. Initially, I thought we had an agreement there, but we didn't. And so not everyone agreed on that. So we can reimburse them. That was always the case. But to get the money to a vendor, we're going to have an AG opinion to decide, can we do it that way? Or do we have to go back to doing it on a reimbursement basis? So that was our solution, is just we can just reimburse as districts buy it. But again, you know, that wasn't the consensus. And so we said, look, we'll let the Attorney General. If he says we can do it that way, we're happy to do it that way.
You're calling for an impeachment.
Give clarity. We have now done this for month after month of political lies and attacks on me. Let's provide clarity. If there's a serious accusation, let's lay it out there for the people of Oklahoma to see. If there is a serious accusation and not just these fake political attacks, let's put it out there. Let's talk about it. Let's have that open proceeding. But look, I think that we need clarity. I don't think we need this behind the scenes, behind closed doors, way of doing things, saying this to this person, saying that to that person. Let's get it all out in the open. If they want to impeach me, let's sit here and have the hearing. If they think there's impeachable offenses, let's lay it out there.
So